This video tutorial will take you through some of the key features of wideband tympanometry and its clinical utility for the pediatric population. Much of what is discussed in this tutorial can also be applied to the adult population when similar pathologies are found. When we consider single frequency tympanometry, such as 226 Hz, a common challenge encounters is understanding the true degree of fluid or air present in the middle ear when we encounter a type C tympanogram. Often, it is only by adopting a watchful waiting approach that we can see how the condition progresses, and this can lead to delays in treatment. And for the pediatric population, any associated hearing loss can have a detrimental effect on their communication development. The additional data provided by performing wideband tympanometry can be used to help determine the degree of fluid in the middle ear space. First of all, we want to ensure we are inspecting a tympanogram with a normal ear canal volume to rule out any other pathology such as a perforation. Then we can consider our single frequency tympanogram. In the first example, we can see an example of a normal tympanogram, often described as type A. The second two examples show our type C tympanograms. But with only this information available, it isn't possible to determine whether the negative pressure is the result of some eustachian tube dysfunction, where the middle ear space is filled with air, or whether the condition has progressed further to the point of there being some fluid present in the middle ear space. Lastly, we have a flat type B tympanogram, suggesting effusion is present in the middle ear space. The examples used here display the 226 Hz frequency. By performing wideband tympanometry, you will also have the 1000 Hz probe tone reading performed within the same measurement, which you can refer to if testing infants under the age of 6 months. The next layer of information provided by wideband tympanometry is the wideband average tympanogram. This measurement displays an average of all the single tone frequencies recorded between 800 and 2000 Hz for children. The range for adults is 375 to 2000 Hz. And this is particularly useful for the pediatric population. The averaging process, just like in evoked potential testing, reduces the effect of unwanted noise from a test subject, who may have been unsettled or upset during the test, and can provide clearer results than a single frequency tympanogram. In the examples on the screen, we can see a greater degree of negative pressure in the average tympanogram in example 3 than in example 2, which could be an indication of more fluid being present in the middle ear space. There is still more data available from the wideband tympanometry measurement to help inform the diagnosis. The absorbance graph is next. As the amount of fluid in the ear increases, the absorbance properties of the middle ear space will decrease. A normal ear is filled with air in the middle ear space, and so here we have a normal absorbance graph. In the next example, we can still see a relatively healthy absorbance graph, suggesting that despite the negative middle ear pressure, this ear is filled with air rather than fluid. However, you will note that the absorbance is decreasing in the lower frequencies compared to our first example. In example 3, the absorbance line is lower down the graph, indicating that there is some fluid present in the middle ear. And finally, we can see a greatly reduced absorbance graph in the case of middle ear effusion. Normative data is provided for absorbance values for different ages, as well as for the wideband average tympanogram. So it's important the correct age group is selected for your test subject. This will be selected by default if the Titan suite is run through a database. During a wideband tympanometry measurement, a value called the resonance frequency is also recorded. This is the probe frequency which is sensitive to a change in both mass and stiffness, and so will change according to pathologies. The resonance frequency for an adult is around 800 to 1200 Hz and 250 to 600 Hz for an infant. In cases where there is suspected middle ear fluid, as this is a mass-dominated pathology, we would expect to see the resonance frequency value decrease with increasing amounts of fluid. Altogether, using the average tympanogram and absorbance graph alongside the single probe tone tympanogram will give more certainty as to the condition of the middle ear.